Shoot diseases of mulberry. Mulberry, Morus species, the food plant of silkworm Bombyx mori L, is cultivated in both tropical and temperate countries of the world. Mulberry is grown under wide range of climatic conditions and is affected by a large number of diseases and pests, and many of them are of great economic importance. The diseases, in addition to the reduction in the leaf yield, also affect the quality of the leaf. Biochemical studies have revealed that the diseased leaves are poor in nutritive values and moisture content. Feeding of such leaves not only affects the growth and development of the silkworms, but also the cocoon yield and silk quality. Recently, sericulture is being extended in new areas and countries, including low temperature and high rainfall areas, which may throw new challenges, since many of the plant pathogens are known to multiply quicker in such conditions. Protection of mulberry from diseases has become more important today than ever before. There are different kinds of diseases of mulberry which are caused by fungi, bacteria, viruses, and nematodes. These diseases are majorly categorized into foliar diseases, stem diseases, or root diseases. Mulberry is mainly affected by five foliar diseases or shoot diseases, such as leaf spot, powdery mildew, leaf rust, leaf blight, and bacterial blight. Let us study one by one today. The first one is leaf spot disease of mulberry. It is one of the major foliar diseases of mulberry caused by fungal pathogen Cercospora moricola, belongs to the order Moniliales of the class Dipteromycetes. This disease is most common in rainy and post-rainy seasons from July to December and prevails up to January-February in South Indian conditions. The disease starts progressing 35 to 45 days after pruning. It reduces about 10% to 20% of the leaf yield depending upon season and variety of mulberry. Symptoms: small irregular brownish spots surrounded with chlorotic rings on the leaves in the initial stages, and as the disease advances, the spots enlarge and coheles, leaving characteristic short hole with yellow halo margin. Leaves become yellow and wither off as disease becomes severe. Disease cycle: the fungus Cercospora moricola produces a compact mass of interwoven cushion-like hyphae, which produce conidia on conidiopores. Conidia are 3 to 7 celled, hyaline, tapering, and measure about 70 by 30 microns in size. The conidia germinate and produce hyphae, which enter the host cells and develop the mycelium. The disease spreads primarily with rain droplets through conidia and takes 10 to 15 days after inoculation for development of the symptoms. The optimal temperature of 24 degree to 26 degree Celsius and prevalence of 70 to 80% relative humidity are most congenial for this fungus. Apart from Cercospora moricola, another leaf spot disease which has recently become a serious threat to mulberry is black leaf spot, which is caused by a Dipteromycetes fungus, Colletotrichum glossporidias. This disease is characterized by dark brown or black necrotic rectangular or polygonal spots of 1 to 3 mm size. Because of small size of spots, this disease is often mistaken as leaf rust. C. glossporidias penetrates mulberry leaves through open stomata by formation of specialized infection vesicles, either over the stomata or within the stomatal cavities. The gray leaf spot is another disease which is most commonly noticed in Gangetic belt of West Bengal, Bihar, and Uttar Pradesh. It is caused by a fungus Pseudocercospora mori belonging to the class Dipteromycetes. This disease symptoms appear first on lower surface of the leaves as small gray to brown colored hyphal mats and mildew like appearance, which later appear as concomitant dark brown necrotic spots on upper surface of the leaves. Temperature ranging between 19 and 30 degrees Celsius favors the disease development. In addition to these, there are many other pathogens causing leaf spot in mulberry, such as Septogloem mori, Alternaria tenuissima, Drichlis yamadi, Ployospora maculanus, Fusarium solani, Myrtaceum roridium and Xanthomonas campestris mori. The symptoms of these diseases caused by said pathogens are slightly different from that of Cercospora moricola, that is, appearance of circular or irregular brownish black spots of varying sizes on leaves. Prevention and management measures of leaf spot disease. Plants growing under stress and with high nitrogenous and phosphatic fertilizers are generally more prone to the leaf spot. Leaf spot infection can be minimized effectively by following some cultural practices such as wider spacing, balanced fertilizer application and field sanitation. Spraying the systemic fungicide such as Bevistin, that is carbendazim, 50% wettable powder solution at the rate of 2% concentration recommended, which reduces up to 70% of the disease. Leaves can be used for silkworm rearing after a safe period of 8 days. Biocontrol agents such as Trichoderma arisianum and Trichoderma pseudoconingi were found to be effective against brown spot disease. Leaf extracts of certain plants such as Adathoda xylinica, Allium sativum, Calotropis gigantea, Celosia argentina, Eucalyptus species, Eupatorium odoratum, Osimum canum, Pimento officinalis, Gingiber officinal, etc. are reported to have inhibitory effect on the germination of conidia of Cercospora moricola. Therefore, the possibilities of utilizing these plant products can also be explored for management of leaf spot in mulberry. Mulberry varieties like K2, S54, MR2, C799, Jodhpur local, Paragaya, RFS135, RFS175 and Almora local are resistant to leaf spot disease, having less than 5% disease incidence. The second most important disease of mulberry is powdery mildew. It is caused by Pilectinia coerulea. It is the second most important disease of mulberry in India and is known to occur in almost all mulberry growing countries of the world. In India, the disease was first reported by Salmon in 1905 in Uthakamand, that is in Tamil Nadu. The P. coerulea belongs to the family Erispacea order Erispales of class Ascomycetes. It is more prevalent in hilly areas than the plains, occurring during rainy and winter season, that is from July to March, and is favored by cool, shady and moist environment. Its intensity reaches maximum during December, February in South Indian conditions. It progressing 40th day after pruning and becoming severe on 70th day. It reduces the leaf yield up to 20% besides deteriorating the leaf quality due to luxuriant mycelial growth on lower surface. Upon feeding mulberry leaves infected with powdery mildew, the silkworms remain smaller in size, resulting in smaller sized cocoons as well as poor quality of silk. Symptoms. The powdery mildew can be easily identified by appearance of white powdery patches on lower surface of the mulberry leaves. As the disease advances, these patches spread and cover entire lower surface of the leaves. White powdery patches on the other side, chlorotic lesions. On severity of the disease, white powdery patches turn to brownish black in color. The leaves become yellow, coarse, less nutritive. Infection on young leaves also causes curling, crinkling, reduction in the leaf width, longitudinal foldings. Feeding silkworms with infected leaves affects the growth and development of the silkworm larva and cocoon characters. Disease cycle. The pathogen of P. coerulea is an ectoparasitite. It obtains nutrients by sending osteria into the epidermal cells through the stomata. The fungus reproduces by both asexual and sexual methods. Asexual reproduction takes place in the initial stages, whereas sexual reproduction takes place in the later stages in the adverse climatic conditions. Asexual reproduction takes place by means of conidia. Conidia are hyaline, unicellular and club shaped, measuring 20 by 30 micrometers, born terminally on septate conidiopores. The liberated conidia disperse through wind current and spreads the disease. The mycelium is unbranched, hyaline and forms a mycelial mat sticking to the leaf surface. The sexual reproduction takes place by the formation of fruiting bodies called cleistothecia by the fusion of Antheridium and Ascogonium. Cleistothecia are covered with numerous colorless needle shaped with ball like swollen basal part appendages. Inside the cleistocidium, 5 to 50 ossei are present, which on maturity are liberated during the favorable conditions by the splitting of the cleistothecia. Each oscus has two oscospores, which on germination produce hyphae and spreads the disease through conidia. Prevention and management measures. Various cultural practices help in reducing the severity of powdery mildew in mulberry. Adoption of wider plant spacing, that is 90 cm by 90 cm, or adopting paired row spacing, that is 150 cm plus 90 cm by 60 cm, and trimming of plants as high bushes provide good ventilation, which helps reducing the powdery mildew incidence because of the decrease in humidity in mulberry gardens. The growing of unwanted trees in and around the mulberry garden is to be avoided, as they create shady condition in mulberry gardens that promotes disease development. Sulfur is the most commonly used chemical against powdery mildew in agricultural crops because of its efficacy, both preventive as well as curative measure, and low cost. However, in mulberry, a systemic fungicide called Bevistin or a copper formulation called Carathen are reported to be the most effective against powdery mildew. Fungicide application should begin during early stages of disease development. Hence, Bevistin or Carathen at the rate of 0.2% can be sprayed on the lower surface of the leaves immediately after noticing the disease symptoms. It is a both protective and a therapeutic. After 3 to 4 days of fungicidal spray, the leaves can be used for silkworm rearing. Yellow ladybird beetle, that is Ilias cincta and Ilias indica, have been reported as biological control agents of powdery mildew. These insects feed on conidia and mycelia of Philoctinia corylia. A species of fungus, Cladosporium, is also reported to be hyperparasitic to conidiospores and conidia of P. corylia on mulberry. Mulberry varieties like Kalia, Kutai, Mandalia, China White, Jodhpur, Punjab Local, Almora Local, Himachal Local, MR2 and S523 are found to be moderately resistant. The third foliar diseases of mulberry is leaf rust. There are two types of rust diseases which affects mulberry plantation, such as leaf rust and red rust. Leaf rust is very common under South Indian tropical climatic conditions, while red rust occurs worldwide, but in India it is mostly confined to North Indian temperate conditions. Leaf rust is one of the economically important diseases of mulberry, causing 10 to 15% of leaf yield loss. Leaf rust disease is caused by Cerithelium fissi. It belongs to the order Uridineales of class Mesidiomycetes. The disease is prevalent during winter and rainy seasons. It starts progressing 45 to 50 days after pruning and becoming severe by 70 days after pruning. The disease reduces the leaf yield up to 10 to 15%. Symptoms: circular, pinnate sized, irregular, reddish to rusty brown spots erupt lesions. Spots appear on lower side of the leaves. Later, the affected leaves become yellowish and wither up prematurely as the disease advances. Disease cycle: the pathogen of C. pisci is a obligate microcyclic rusty fungi, exist primarily as mycelium, uridinia or uridia, and uridiospores or uridiospores. Each uridinium produces numerous uridiospores, which are oval to globose, acunculated or spiny, uninucleate, measuring 15 to 18 or by 12 by 15 micrometers and produced singly on uridiopores. They have depressed germ pores on their surface that gives rise to germ tubes. The germ tubes, prior to entering leaf tissues, produce characteristic aprosoria. From each primary infection, hyphae emerge. The infection Hypae penetrate the leaf directly through cuticle and epidermis, but not through stomata. Although the germ tubes while extending over leaf surface often encounter stomata, they never form oppressoria over them. Iridinia with cellular peridium enclosing subsessile highly thick walled iridiospores are produced towards lower epidermis irrespective of the site of penetration. Prevention and management measures: timely utilization of leaves, especially during winter months, and adoption of wider spacing are important cultural practices that reduce the rust disease. Intercropping of mulberry with soybean, green gram, forage crops such as ragi and maize between mulberry rows under wider spacing also reduces the rust incidence. Spraying of suitable fungicides like Kavach or Foltaf 80 at 0.2% concentration or sulfur dust at 0.5 concentration immediately after appearance of disease symptoms helps in management of rust disease. Leaves can be fed to silkworms after 10 to 12 days of spraying safely. Mulberry varieties like AB into Phil, K2 into Cosin, and Almora local are found to be moderately resistant. Red rust. This disease is widespread in subtropical countries like China, Japan, USSR, Korea, etc. In India, it is a minor disease seen occasionally in northern parts of the country like Himachal Pradesh, Uttar Pradesh, West Bengal, and northeastern regions. A basidiomycetes fungus, Acidium mori, is the causal organism of red rust in mulberry. It spreads through azeospores that disperse by wind and water current. Azeospores produce germ tubes which enter the leaf tissues either directly through the leaf epidermis or stomata. A. mori affects leaves, petioles, young buds, and shoots. The affected buds become swollen, curl up in abnormal shape with primary, mainly slightly protruded yellow spots on them. On affected leaves, numerous small, round, shiny yellow color protruded spots appear on both the leaf surfaces. If the shoot and petiole are affected, the fungus spreads through vascular bundles. Prevention and management measures. During the spring season, when the buds sprout, especially in the northeastern regions of India, the rust affected plant should be removed. The disease can also be controlled by spraying fungicides like Bavistin or Foltaf at the rate of 0.2% concentration or sulfur dust at 0.5% concentration. The leaf blight. The leaf blight in mulberry is caused by both fungi as well as bacteria. The fungal leaf blight is prevalent mainly in tropical regions, whereas bacterial blight is worldwide in occurrence. Leaf blight causes serious damage to mulberry foliage by destroying the leaf lamina. Fungal leaf blight. Fungal leaf blight in mulberry is mainly caused by species of Alternaria, Fusarium, Elementosporium, and Colletotrichum. Among them, Alternaria and Fusarium species are the most commonly observed causing leaf blight in mulberry. Fungal leaf blight causes sudden and extensive damage to foliage, rendering them to become unfit for feeding silkworms. It is more common during summer under water stress, rain-fed and semi-irrigated conditions. Alternaria leaf blight. Many Alternaria species are reported to cause leaf spot and leaf blight disease in different plant crops that led to drastic economic losses all over the world. Most of the Alternaria species live saprophytically and have ability to become parasitic under favorable circumstances. Occurrence of Alternaria leaf blight disease in mulberry was first observed on seedlings. Later on, it was commonly seen occurring on established plants in mulberry gardens. Disease symptoms. The disease is characterized by drying of leaves which starts from the leaf tip and later extends to the base covering entire leaf lamina and the petiole. As the disease advances, severely affected leaves become yellow, wither and fall off. Mulberry seedlings are found to be more vulnerable for the attack of Alternaria and seedlings are dried within 10 to 15 days after infection. Causal organism and disease cycle. 5 isolates of Alternaria, which belongs to the order Moniliales family Demetiaceae of the class Deuteromyces, have been reported to cause leaf blight in mulberry. Alternaria can easily be identified by morphology of its large conidia. The fungus produces Oliveraceous black mycelia on potato dextrose agar medium. Conidia pores and conidia are yellowish brown in color. The conidia pores are simple, straight, smooth, 1 to 3 septate, measuring 3 to 5 micrometer by 24 to 60 micrometers, with a pore at the apex. Conidia are narrow, ovoid to ellipsoidal, measuring 8 to 12 micrometer by 26 to 27 micrometer, with 3 to 8 transverse septa and 1 to 3 longitudinal septa. Conidia germinate by producing more than one germ tubes, which terminate into finger-like projections called oppressoria. These oppressoria help the pathogen to enter the leaf tissues by direct penetration through leaf cuticle and epidermis or through wounds. Alternaria remains dormant in infected leaves and survives in soil on plant debris and can infect the new crop when the condition is congenial. Temperature ranging between 28 and 30 degrees Celsius favors the multiplication of the fungus. Fusarium leaf blight. Fusarium species are widespread and common in soil, aerial and subterranean plant pots. In mulberry, Fusarium species being airborne as well as soil-borne in nature, cause both foliar and stem and root diseases. Fusarium species are responsible for destruction of the entire mulberry plant or plant pots, as they cause leaf spot, leaf blight, bud blight, twig blight, stem cutting rot or root rot. Various species of Fusarium cause leaf blight in mulberry. Fusarium lateratium and Fusarium oxysporum, Fusarium solani also causes leaf blight or wilt of mulberry in other sericultural countries. Disease symptoms. Symptoms of leaf blight first appear as marginal browning or blackening of leaves, which later spread towards midrib, leading to defoliation. In case of twig blight, affected branches become feeble and fragile with irregular black lesions on the stem surface in certain cases, which later coheles and spread longitudinally, resulting in splitting and drying of the branches. Causal organisms and disease cycle. Fusarium polydorosium belong to the family Moniliaceae, order Moniliales of class Deuteromycetes, is commonly observed causing leaf blight disease in India. The fungi hypa give rise to simple conidiopores, which grow out on the leaf surface in clusters, resulting in the development of symptoms. Conidiopores produce two types of conidia, such as micro and macro conidia. Micro conidia are single celled and ovoid or oblong in shape. Macro conidia are eye-line, elongate, filiform and multiseptate with pointed ends, measuring 14.3 micromillimeter by 5.02 micromillimeter. Each microconidium gives rise to one to several germ tubes, which grow towards the stomata and penetrate the mulberry leaf directly through open stomata. F. Palladiorosium does not produce oppressoria or any other specialized penetration structure. The pathogen is generally a soil inhabitant and survives in crop debris in the form of chlamydospores. Prevention and management of measures. Adequate application of nitrogen fertilizer reduces incidence of diseases. Leaf extract of neem, that is Azadirachta indica, is very effective, and application of fungicide dithane M45 have been found to be effective against fungal leaf blight. Bacterial leaf blight. The bacterial leaf blight is caused by Pseudomonas mori. It belongs to the order Pseudomonales of the class Schizomycetes and was first reported from Nainital district of Uttar Pradesh and subsequently from Dharwad in Karnataka. Of late, The disease has been observed to occur in almost all mulberry growing areas in India. The disease is known to occur during rainy season and cause 5 to 10% leaf yield loss. Symptoms. The initial symptoms of the disease include small water soaked irregular spots on the lower surface of the leaves, which later turn brown and finally into black spots with sticky bacterial ooze in humid weather. Infected leaves turn yellow, curl and fall off. In addition to causing defoliation, the disease impairs the nutritive value of mulberry leaves, making unsuitable for silkworm rearing. Young leaves are susceptible. Bacterium is also known to cause stem canker in mulberries. Stem at this region easily breaks off. Disease cycle. Soil is the primary source of bacterial inoculum. The secondary infection of the disease takes place through irrigation, cultivation activities, mechanical injuries and also biological agents. The bacterium is rod shaped, measuring 0.9 to 1.4 micron by 1.84.5 micron. It is a gram positive, encapsulated, no endospore. Colonies on nutrient agar are white, circular, smooth, flat and translucent. The thermal activation point is 52 degrees Celsius. The bacterium spreads mainly through rain splash and insects. Pathogen entering the leaves through stomata or wounds caused by sap sucking pests. It survives on plant debris in soil. Prevention and management measures. The disease could be effectively controlled by spraying 5 to 100 ppm solution of streptocycline or streptopenicillin and streptomycin sulfate. Affected plant should be uprooted and burnt. The contaminated soil should be exposed for sun drying. Management of mulberry pests and sanitation of field is also effectively avoids the spread of infection. Folt up to be most effective, followed by mancozeb and captan at 0.25% under in vitro conditions. Thank you.